Okay, so hi guys, John here once again, and welcome back to another video of The Present. As you can see, meron tayong guest ngayon, which is si Mr. Robbi Samson of First Metro Securities. And topic natin ngayon is about Philippine stock market, anything that we want to understand about the Philippine stock market, especially right now na medyo, you know, with the coronavirus situation and yung may ibang markets na bumababa. So mag-adjust tayo doon. And kaya tayo actually, just for everybody's information, we just had a chat this morning. What if mag-live kaya tayo? Like today. And then boom! Kaya nandito tayo ngayon. Sige. So, Robbi, kamusta ka? How's everything?
Okay naman, okay naman. So we've shifted to work from home. So the whole Davao team has shifted to work from home. So we're still accommodating clients naman, we're still opening accounts, we're still monitoring the market. Yun lang, nasa bahay lang kami ngayon. So imbis na nakapantalon, naka-shorts na lang.
Naka-shorts na lang. Sometimes nakasando rin tayo, wala na. Nasa bahay lang tayo eh. So ganito, since the marami kasing hot topic ngayon pagdating sa stock market kasi alam naman natin na parang for some, natatakot yung mga tao kasi bumababa yung presyo ng stock market. But for some, they see it as an opportunity to invest in the marketplace, which is good. It really depends lang kung ano yung education ng person, yung financial intelligence niya. And ang common kasi na tinatanong ngayon is, in your opinion, how long ba tong coronavirus situation in your opinion mag-last?
Okay. Actually this situation is unique, no? Kasi usually yung mga past na catalyst for stock market crashes, especially yung recent one, yung nung nag-recession ng 2008. Ano siya, medyo it could be solved by finance, no? By financial stimulus packages, quantitative easing. So medyo mas madaling i-project na pagka nag-inject ka ng ganitong pera sa economy, posibleng ganito yung maging epekto. The difference right now nga is this one is a health crisis. So nagkataon pa na the virus that we're dealing with is highly contagious. So it really is hard to say when exactly things will get back to normal. The good thing lang is yun nga, especially today, di ba? Reported number of cases nag 70 something na lang, which is down from 300 the past 2 days, tapos 500 3 days ago. So medyo sana yun yung effect nung quarantine na ini-implement ng government natin. In case naman na yun nga, and then we are able to potentially end this quarantine within the next month or so, I'm still assuming hindi naman automatically babalik to normal yung economy natin, di ba, yung buhay natin. I'm sure kahit na ma-lift na yung quarantine, siguro yung government will still be very, very cautious when it comes to implementing yung social distancing measures, yung pag-check ng temperatures, yung pag-ensure siguro na dapat nakamaskara lahat ng lalabas ng bahay, stuff like that. So, hindi naman din natin masasabi na pagka nag-end ito by April, by May, okay na ulit. Ganong kadami na ulit yung tao sa Abreeza, ganong kadami na ulit yung mamamasyal or magta-travel outside. Yung mga ganon, di ba? So, baka mahirap i-expect yung ganon. Which makes it harder din on our end to project when will the economy go back to where it was before this whole thing started. Parang ganun.
Kasi that's true, like parang kumawala man yung coronavirus situation, it doesn't mean that everything's going to go back to normal immediately. It takes time, di ba? Kasi sometimes sa ating utak meron pa tayong fear na hala, what if hindi pa natapos, you know? Tapos maglala yung sakit. So, yes. Totoo yun. Uh-oh. And one fact na nakita talaga natin sa news is that the economy is getting a hit financially as well. The financial markets are getting a hit because of the coronavirus situation. Mm-hmm. And agree rin ako sa sinabi mo, parang this is like the first thing na health crisis siya at the same time na apektuhan yung financial markets. Mm-hmm. So for the past, ano kasi parang, you know, like Great Recession and Depression, it's really more about financial markets lang. Mm-hmm. So parang double whammy ito nangyari sa atin ngayon. Yes. Mm-hmm. Right? So, ang tanong kasi, merong ibang tao na nakapag-invest na sila ng money way back 2019 or even 2018 even. Mm-hmm. And sa ngayon, when they are checking their portfolio, no, regardless if it's BUL, mutual fund, or like a specific stock that they invested, baba talaga most of the time. Mm-hmm. Most of the companies that they are investing. And what's the best thing to do ba if you're the investor na yun yung nakikita mo sa portfolio mo? Pula lahat. What do you think? Like, what's your advice on for those people?
Okay. So, ano, no? I'm sure mahirap i-digest yung nangyari, no? Especially if you are going to see your portfolio in the red day in and day out, no? But what I would like to tell investors like that, no? Or any other people who have matters like that, is siguro by now it's too late to sell. No, kasi bumagsak na yung market natin ng around 30, 40, 50%. So most likely yung losses nila ganun na din. 'Di ba? I highly doubt na 10% lang yung loss. If ever 10% pa lang yung loss mo, yan, pwede ka pa mag-cut niyan. You can cut your losses pa and then just re-enter at better opportunities next time. But if your losses mga 50% na, hold on to it na lang, no? Hold on to it na lang kasi nga ang isa lang naman na positive, no, na nakikita natin na nangyari from this pandemic is that we've seen the government act swiftly when it comes to supporting the economy. Diba? Right now, syempre mahirap pa sabihin kung gaano ka-effective yung mga measures na ginagawa nila, pero at least meron silang ginagawa. So on the onset pa lang of the virus, nakita natin, 'di ba, nag-approve sila ng stimulus package for the tourism industry. Majority nun is to help the tourism industry, so that's good. After nun, nagkaroon sila nung parang what we call quantitative easing, which is essentially the BSP buying government security. So in effect, para silang nagbigay ng 300 billion pesos sa government para meron silang panggastos panglaban dito sa virus na to and to help other businesses. So we've also seen the DTI tell mga lenders na pautangin niyo yung mga negosyo na nangangailangan, stuff like that. So may coordination naman. May coordination naman tayo nakikita. And that is one thing that we should be siguro positive about, na hindi man natin mapigilan na mag-slow down yung economy in the next few months or maybe within 2020, pero at least it increases the chance na baka naman mapabilis din yung recovery natin kasi active yung government interventions na ginagawa natin. So with that said, that gives me kumbaga more confidence to tell people na kung nag-lose ka na ng 40-50%, siguro bit by especially habang bumabagsak yung market, no, when things go red in the stock market, you can slowly add to your positions, no. Wag mo lang biglain, hindi yung may 100,000 ka ngayon, gusto mo sa Lunes pag open ng market i-invest mo agad yung buong 100,000, di ba? So i-stagger mo lang siya. Maglagay ka ng pa 5,000 every 2 days, every 3 days, or every time pula yung market, lagay ka ng 10,000. Ganong strategy. Kasi the market naman has shown the ability to recover. So, the past recession ng 2008, bumagsak ang Philippine stock market by 48% in 2008. The following year, because of the measures taken by governments worldwide, our stock market went up by 63%. So, ganun kabilis, wow, yung recovery. Pero yun, of course, again, kasi yun, financial crisis yun. So medyo mas mabilis masold. Kasi pera lang talaga, malaking bagay na. Dito, kahit may pera yung tao, hindi naman magastos kasi hindi makalabas ng bahay, di ba? So yeah. Ibang usapan siya. Pero at least yun nga, at least may intervention ng government. We've seen, di ba, we've seen also DSWD convert some stadiums and buildings in Luzon into mga treatment facilities. So yung mga ganung bagay nakikita mo na uy, nilalabanan natin to. And the fact na nilalabanan natin to, pinapangunahan natin to, nag-iingat tayo. The fact that we see those measures being taken by people in power gives us kumbaga confidence na baka makaraos naman talaga tayo dito in sooner rather than later. Parang ganun.
Yeah, so technically if you already have an investment way back and then now that you can see that your portfolio is red as much as possible, it's too late, parang too late na to get too out of the market.
Yes.
The
yes,
moment you liquidate mo, yung paper loss mo magiging loss talaga, cash loss.
Loss talaga. Oh, eh historically naman pag bumagsak ang market by 40-50% in a span of a year or so, ano yun, steep na yun. Usually, ano na yun, medyo significant drop na yun. So, hindi naman natin masasabi na this is the lowest we can go, pero malaki-laking drop na din talaga yun. So, huwag ka na lang magbenta ngayon kung ganun na kalaki loss mo. Bumili ka na lang slowly, habang mura pa siya.
Mm. Okay. Ito rin, meron akong natanggap na personal message from different people. Kasi nga, nagpalabas kami ng video, I think, 2 weeks ago. And ang sinabi ko doon is, baba na yung market, right? Mm-hmm. So since baba na yung market, this is also an opportunity for investors to come in.
Mm-hmm.
So because I said that, ang sabi naman ng mga ibang messages na, sir, meron akong 100,000 na life savings. Life savings to ha. And then, since na-mention nyo po na maganda mag-invest sa stock market niyan kasi nga mababa siya, for sale, quote-unquote, for sale. Is it a good strategy for me to put all my life savings sa stock market? Anong masasabi mo doon?
Siyempre, not be a good decision. Definitely, you have to diversify, no? Especially when it comes to investing in the stock market, make sure that the amount that you invest in the stock market is something that you can afford to lose. So, maliit naman yung chance na mag-zero talaga yung in-invest mo sa stock market, pero hindi din imposible na bumagsak siya by 50%. Di ba? So, as we've seen right now. So, make sure pa din na even for me, no, na nagtatrabaho sa stock market talaga, wag mo i-invest yung buong life savings mo sa stock market. Make sure you diversify well enough na if ever bumaba, especially ito, health crisis. Optimistic tayo. We're seeing some positive signs. We're seeing activity from private corporates and then the government to help mitigate the crisis, no? Pero talaga hindi natin masasabi. It could last until the end of the month. It could last until 6 months from now. We don't know. So it really would be a very, very bad idea to put all of your life savings in the stock market. Diversify. Put some in bonds. Kasi yung bonds, nagbibigay sila ng stable income. So you can make maybe 4-5% sa ganong investments. Pwede ka din maglagay yon. Of course, sa stock market. Pwede kang maglagay sa cooperatives, di ba? We have a lot of cooperatives here naman. So yun, so you just try to find out yung pag-ibig fund din. Pwede ka din maglagay doon. So just try to find out the different asset classes that you can invest in. But definitely don't put all of your eggs in one basket.
True. So at least guys, if you're watching this video, hindi lang ako nagsabi na wag niyo yung gawin na lahat ng life savings mo ilagay mo stock market or any asset class kasi nga we never know what's gonna happen. So at least coming from Robbi Samson as well, no? And ganito, so fundamentally, we can see na marami naman talagang mga news na sometimes it's Sa ngayon, ang na-notice ko lang is there are more negative news compared to positive news. Mm-hmm. Kaya nga parang nakakapagod na rin mag-open ng Facebook ngayon eh kasi puro na new negative news yung nakikita natin. Mm-hmm. How about sa technical side of it? What are the charts telling us? Is it on a downtrend or is it sideways or uptrend? Ano ba yung nakikita mo sa charts natin for those people who like to see it on a technical aspect?
Okay, sige. So I actually prepared a chart for this. So let me pull up lang yung chart ng PSEI natin. So I think it's this one. Yeah. Ayan. So yan yung chart ngayon ng PSEI. So this is a weekly chart. So ibig sabihin this is a candlestick chart, no? So one candle means 1 week. So mm-hmm. it's one whole trading week. And as we can see right now, we are at 5,347 points. So makikita natin yung purple line, yan yung previous uptrend natin dating back to 2013. And as you can see earlier this year, na-break yung uptrend na yan, yung blue circle na nilagay ko. Na-break yan, and nung na-break yan, effectively, tapos na yung uptrend. So, tapos na-compound pa siya because of the coronavirus news, kaya naging very rapid yung pagbagsak ng stock market natin. Kung makikita ninyo, di ba, dire-diretso siya pagbagsak. Within a span of 3 weeks, 4 weeks, it went from 7,200 points to a low of 4,000 points. So, it lost parang effectively 3,000 plus points in a span of 3 weeks, which is very, very huge. Parang, halos kalahati ng value niya nawala in just 3 short weeks. So ngayon, makikita natin, I drew this parang blue range sa baba. So that shows us where we are right now, na posibleng yan yung trading range ng stock market natin. So thankfully, over the past 2 weeks, nakita natin yung stock market natin, medyo nag-normalize. So for the past 2 weeks, nakikita natin green na yung color ng kandila, meaning umaakyat siya. No, umaakyat siya. And our initial range is between 4,040 points to 5,600 points. So, pag sinabi nating range, yan yung ina-expect natin na diyan posibleng maglaro yung stock market natin for the foreseeable future. So, maglalaro lang yan anywhere between 5,600 to 4,040. So, ang maganda dyan, kung medyo active trader ka, gusto mong bumili pag malapit siya sa baba, which is malapit sa 4,000. Gusto mong magbenta pagka malapit siya sa taas, which right now is malapit siya sa 5,600. So that's one strategy that we can employ. One thing lang, if you'll see the parang the green zone on top, no? May nilagay akong parang green zone dyan sa taas na mayroong nakakabit na green arrow. That represents a possible resistance level in case maging strong talaga yung sentiment ng market natin over the next few weeks. So I think pagka makikita natin na mag-i-improve talaga yung situation natin as it relates to the virus, meaning pagka kumunti siguro yung nai-infect, kumunti yung new cases, kumunti yung namamatay, dumami yung nakaka-recover, people might be more willing to start getting back into the stock market. And if so, pwedeng umakyat yung stock market natin potentially up to 6,500. Kung hindi naman, at over the next few weeks, over the next few days, makita natin nag-i-increase ulit yung number of cases, pwede naman siyang bumalik dun sa low natin of around 4,000 points. So, either way, kung ibig sabihin lang nun, kung bibili ka ngayon at 5,347 at kung sakali mang umakyat siya to 6,500, pwede kang kumita ng approximately 22%. Pagka naman nag-invest ka ngayon at ang dumating na balita hindi maganda at bumagsak siya, pwedeng bumagsak all the way to 4,000 points yung market at you can also lose about 23% of your value. So that's where we are right now when it comes to the whole index. So yung strategy dyan is yun, just make sure you understand what you're getting into. You know the scenarios that can possibly play out. Pero yung blue range na yan, yung blue rectangular box dyan is essentially your trading range right now.
Mm. All right. For everybody's information, yung Philippine Stock Index, that's the top 30 companies, no? Ng Pilipinas na nakalagay sa isang index. So parang isang portfolio. So this is the performance of those 30 companies in one. Kaya parang ito yung figure, ito yung chart natin. And Robbi, for the benefit of everyone, ano ba yung meaning or simplified version ng points? Ano ba yung meaning ng points? When you say 5,600 points, ano bang ibig sabihin nun?
Ah, okay. Yung points kasi, parang yun yung measure of the activity of the index. Kasi diba, we said nga, the index is comprised of 30 different companies. So how do we measure the performance or the value of those 30 companies? Diba? So kaya yung stock market, they came up with a parang point system to provide a clear indicator of the value of those 30 companies in the index. And since hindi naman siya presyo, hindi siya pesos, points siya. So yun yung value ng index mo. Yun yung value ng 30 companies sa loob na yan. Expressed siya in points.
Ayun. So guys, at least yung points is parang ano, the more points, pag malaki yung points, ibig sabihin the market is like doing well. Mm. But kung bumaba yung points, then the market is like slowing down. So ganun. Yun yung ibig sabihin ng points. Baka magtaka kasi, anong points? Yun.
Basically, all ano right. Lang siya, it's a way for us to determine whether things became better or worse for that particular period. Diba? So, kware, nag-trading today, how do we measure whether umakyat ang market or bumagsak? So, we measure it in points. Kasi ang daming laman ng index eh. 30 companies siya. So, hindi mo naman pwedeng sabihin sa tao na parang inefficient to say to the public na each of these stocks went up ganun. So, you need one value that will automatically tell the complete story of the 30 companies in it. So, yun yung points.
Ayun. All right. So, knowing this na ito yung top 30 companies which is the PSI, ang ano naman ngayon is that, sir, let's say this is meron akong extra cash. So, good, extra cash yun. And hindi kasi ako sure kung anong companies ang magandang invest ngayon. Like, I would say na maganda pa rin yung company pero as of now, it is undervalued. So in your personal opinion, sa yung expertise, like let's say ikaw mismo, you have extra cash regardless of what amount that is, what are the top three companies that you would like to invest in during this time?
Okay, so kami sa First Metro Securities, the sector that we like the most, especially in this time, is yung the consumer staple sector. So pag sinabi natin consumer staples, yan na yung laging kinakain, laging kinoconsume ng general public, di ba? Whether maganda ang takbo ng ekonomiya or pangit, they purchase these things. So yan na yung mga groceries, di ba? Yung mga sardinas, tinapay, kanin, ganon. So we tend to gravitate toward corporations that manufacture consumer staple products. So right now, actually, yun, nagkataon nga talaga, all of our, majority of our stock picks right now are found in the consumer staples segment. Right now, we like see pure gold. I'll show the stats later, but we like pure gold. We like Robinson's retail, and we like Universal Robina Corporation, URC, yung gumagawa ng Jack and Jill. So, siguro better if isa-isahin natin. So, I'll just show first yung si Universal Robina. Ayan. So, this is Universal Robina, no? Ang price niya right now is 103 pesos per share. So, why do we like Universal Robina? We like Universal Robina kasi nga, yung majority ng products niya, they cater to the mass market talaga. Diba? Even personally, no? Even personally, nung nag-start yung lockdown, yung quarantine, nung nag-stock up na kami ng groceries para sa bahay, talagang we want to maximize yung pera, di ba? Gusto kong paano isagarin yung ma-afford ng pera ko. And so yung ini-stock up namin, yung mga medyo affordable, yung matagal mag-expire. So yun, stock up ka ng mga Magic Flakes, di ba? Nissin, di ba? Magic Chips, Mr. Chips, Piatos, yung mga ganun. So kasi yan yung mga kinoconsume mo talaga. Kahit na medyo mahirap ang sitwasyon, kinoconsume siya. So that's one thing that we particularly like about the products that URC sells. They cater to the mass market. And right now, given the uncertainty of the virus situation, talagang magbe-benefit sila kasi sila yung ipaprioritize ng mga tao. Diba? Ang priority nila is paano ko sasagarin yung pera ko kasi hindi ko alam kung hanggang kailan maglalast itong virus. So gusto ko sulitin yung mga binibili ko. Hindi muna ako dun sa mga super imported na mga produkto kung middle class ka or ano. Gusto mo medyo i-maximize yung pera mo. And so Universal Robina should be one of those companies that benefit from it. Kasi meron silang yung kape, meron sila. Yung noodles, meron sila. Biscuit, meron sila. So they should benefit from it. Hindi naman natin sinasabing lalaki ng sobra yung earnings nila for this year. Pero at least sila yung one of the few companies that could be least affected by the virus. Kasi pinapatronize pa din yung products nila even in these conditions. So as we can see here, no, 103 pesos ang price ni URC right now. Over to the right-hand side of the screen, makikita niyo yung consensus target. And yung average consensus target, ang sabi dyan, 159.69, which means all the top brokerage firms in the country believe that the value of URC should be 100, essentially 160 pesos. So 103 pa lang siya ngayon, pero ang dapat na presyo niya is 160. So that offers you significant upside pa din. Kaya, yun yung meaning nun. So, kaya gusto namin si URC right now because of that fact.
All right. So, is it safe to say that URC is somehow undervalued sa ngayon?
Yes, yes. From a fundamental perspective, definitely valued siya. Kasi if we look at the chart of URC, let me just get the chart. If we look at the chart of URC, so this is the chart of URC, kita natin, firm downtrend siya. Downtrend pa din siya. Pero yung target price or yung consensus target price natin at 159.7, at current prices, kung bibili ka at 103 at ibebenta mo sa around 159 pesos, ang upside mo niyan, 55%. So that's significant, di ba? Malaki yun. Hindi basta-basta yun. So assuming na umakyat nga siya, assuming na sundin din ng sentiment ng tao yung nakikita ng mga professional brokerage firms and researchers. Kung naman conservative ka, sabi mo, ay baka bumagsak pa ulit yung market, maghihintay na lang ako, bumagsak pa siya konti. Assuming nabibili ka at around 82 pesos naman, mas mag-i-increase na yung upside mo. So, pwede ka nang kumita kung magbebenta ka at the same price as 159 pesos, that would be around 90% upside. So, that is very, very significant. So, definitely, from a fundamental perspective, undervalued si URC.
All right. since undervalued si URC, for ano, ilan ba yung ano, ilan ba yung board lot ng URC?
Board lot ng URC is just 10 shares. So you can buy, you can invest in URC for as little as 10 shares. So that's around 1,000 pesos. So you can invest in URC for as low as approximately 1,000 pesos.
So guys, kung meron tayong 1,000 pesos, baka pwede niyong i-consider ang URC, di ba?
Yes, yes. Mm-hmm.
Sige.
Mm-hmm. So the next one naman, the next one that we like, the one I mentioned is Pure Gold. So si Pure Gold, medyo obvious, di ba? Ngayon, sarado ang malls. Ngayon, sarado yung mga sinehan, sarado yung mga entertainment venues, pero yung pila sa mga supermarkets natin, mahaba pa din. Diba? So, essentially, yun yung rason kung bakit still Pure Gold remains a solid stock pick of ours. Kasi nga, medyo mas minimal yung effect ng virus sa kanya compared to other listed companies. So, ang isa pang kagandahan kay Pure Gold, especially sa Luzon kung saan mas madami silang branches, a lot of their stores are standalone, di ba? Standalone sila. Mm-hmm. So, hindi sila part ng mall lang. Although, kahit naman True. Yung mall store, mall groceries, open pa din naman. Pero sila, standalone sila. Tapos, medyo mas madami silang locations. So, supposedly, okay pa din sila. Right now, si Pure Gold, 38.7 pesos per share. In fact, kahapon, up siya by 6%. Di ba? So, malaki yun. Up siya by 6% yesterday. The consensus target price is 52 pesos per share. 52.18. So, again, undervalued siya. So, if we look at the chart ulit of Pure Gold, yan. So, ganito naman. So, 52 pesos ang target price. Kung bibili ka ngayon sa presyo niya, that represents an upside of about 34%. Pagka naman hinintay mo ulit na magbumalik siya dun sa recent low niya at around 25 pesos ata yun or something, 26, tas magbebenta ka pa din at 52, essentially, your up is double. 100%.
So, weekly chart pa rin to, no?
This is still a weekly chart. No? So, we use the weekly chart kasi hindi naman siguro active traders talaga lahat ng nanonood. So, medyo medium term perspective natin.
Yeah.
Long term, medium term. Yung mga target prices kasi na yan, usually, good for 1 year yan. Good for 12 months.
So, ang laki nung spike nung ano, nung parang 2 weeks before? Laki ng akyat.
Laki. Yung bumagsak siya, tapos umakyat siya. Tapos the following week, ang laki ng inakyat niya. This week, medyo okay-okay pa din naman. Green pa din naman siya. Although, nag-close siya lower than last week's close. So, yan. Pero still, yan. Pure Gold offers significant upside, even at current levels. And
nice,
yung,
nice.
And yung last, of our picks is si Robinson's Retail. So si Robinson's Retail yan. Robinson's Retail medyo similar sa story ni Pure Gold, 'di ba? Sarado lahat ng establishments, yung Abreeza na mall sarado, pero si Robinson's Retail, yung supermarket, yung department store bukas pa din. So tas yung Stout Star Drug, which is part of Robinson's Retail, open pa din. So, because of that, we give na, again, yun, hindi siya kasing affected ng ibang kumpanya dito sa pandemic na to. So, right now, it's trading at 56 pesos per share. The average target price is 87 pesos per share. So, that, again, represents significant upside. So, if we look again at the charts, ayan. So, halos magkakamukha lang yung charts nila actually.
Yun nga eh.
Diba?
Parang the same lang.
Pareho lang, di ba? Kasi bumagsak yung market. So, magkakapareho lang yan. Lahat yan nasa downtrend. So, kung bibili ka ngayon at ibebenta mo sa target price of 87 pesos, that would be an upside of about 55%. If you wait naman until it goes back to near its low, its recent low at around 42 pesos something, 42, 43, that will give you an upside of about 97%. So, malalaki yun. Although, ano, para lang mabalance, no? Kasi baka ang isipin ng mga viewers, sobrang optimistic na talagang, hindi, if you'll notice, no, yung mga target price natin na 87 pesos, that is below the recent high of 105 pesos per share. Now, yung high na high ni RRHI nung August 2018. So, ibig sabihin, even if malaki ang upside nyo, we do not really expect things to go back to normal soon. Di ba? We do not expect things to go back to normal soon. So, we have to be cautious. Pa din, we have to be vigilant na even if we're presenting these charts, these figures na maganda ang upside, you have to understand pa din na there is risk involved here. Kasi pagka nakita mo, uy, Robinson's Retail, pwede akong kumita ng 50% or 100%, baka ang maging thinking is yung life savings ko talaga dapat ayagay ko dito. Di ba? Yung ganon. So, we should really refrain from doing that. Let's invest the amount that we can afford to lose in the stock market. But definitely, ang daming kumpanya ngayon na severely undervalued.
Yun. Yun, guys.
Yun. So, yun yung picks namin.
Yun yung picks nila, Robbi, sa First Metro Securities. So, Pure Gold, URC, and then the last one is, anong yung last one?
RRHI.
Robinson's Retail. Ayun. So, parang, again guys, before you even invest, kasi yun yung stock picks nila, but it doesn't mean na yun din yung sayo. So, you also have to do your own research about it and see what you can do. But at least, based on fundamentals and technicals, alam naman talaga natin na it's really undervalued. And these companies are companies that we can see, literally, we can physically see that they exist. No? So, they are legitimate and established na talaga. So, pero wag naman sana tayo mag-expect na the moment we buy right now, on the next month, ma-times 2 na yung pera natin. Hindi sa ganun. Alright? So, yun lang. Okay. Thank you so much, Robbi, for sharing that parang grabe na information.
Sure.
So, valuable. Masyado yun, valuable. Okay. Ito naman. Since that's sa yun yung napansin natin sa mga stock picks ninyo. How about yung mga companies na feeling ninyo na or feeling mo na parang you should be careful to invest in these companies? Kasi parang, you see that they are on a downtrend. One of the factors that we consider sa investing din, di ba, is parang, let's say, kung consistent na bumababa yung kanyang earnings for the past how many years, parang, uy, red alert ka na konti, yes. Nun. Maybe something is wrong with the company, with the leadership of the company, or how they are spending the money and things like that. But lalo na ngayon, nag-crisis pa talaga, so that's an additional burden. Mm-hmm. The question is, sa iyong perspective, ano ba yung mga companies na feeling mo na medyo challenging to invest?
No. Okay. So siguro the first thing that comes to the mind of many, no, is yung mga affected talaga by the virus, specifically siguro one thing is the tourism industry, di ba? Sa amin, in our case, we frequently hold events outside the Philippines, outside Davao, so we go all over the place, no? And we had to cancel all of those events, unfortunately, because of the virus. So those are lost revenues for hotels, airlines. So right now, siguro, if we were to specify sector, siguro yung airline industry, no? Airline industry, yan, ma-travel. Yan, maapektuhan talaga sila. Ilang araw nang may lockdown, may mga canceled flights from almost everywhere. So definitely, their revenues will take a hit. I even saw a report saying na, 'di ba, yung PAL and Cebu Pacific were coordinating with the government to work out some form of assistance or support. Kasi nga, medyo they anticipate ano, lost revenues for the foreseeable. Kasi yun nga, di ba? Parang supposing na ma-lift yung quarantine by the end of April, does that mean 1 week later, komportable ka ng mag-travel, di ba? So, siguro hindi naman, di ba? Kung maiiwasan mo lang, kung hindi naman essential travel yun, siguro, i-delay mo na lang siya. So, hindi naman yun babalik to normal agad. So, even if the, hindi lang yung quarantine ang issue dito, it's really the whole sentiment of the public na is it really safe to go back to the way things were? So, until people are really, really sure of that, and syempre, paano ba sila magiging sure? It will always come from the data. Diba? Confirmed cases, number of recoveries, infection rate, number of deaths, kung may vaccine na ba, kung may gamot na ba, kung effective ba yung mga tinetest nilang medication, treatments, stuff like that. So, kaya talagang tatamaan yung airline industry.
Yeah.
Aside from that, siguro gaming industry. Diba? Especially in the Philippines, yung mga integrated resorts natin, yung mga casinos natin, a lot of their patrons are usually foreigners, di ba? So ngayon, bawal lumipad, takot yung mga mayayaman lumipad sa Pilipinas para maglaro. So I'm sure naapektuhan sila. Yung mga closures. So yan, those are the two industries that come to mind when it comes to those that will be affected mostly greatly by the virus.
Yeah. Kasi totoo 'yun, pagdating naman sa airlines, mura yung tickets ngayon. Pero walang travel.
Usually siguro business travel lang 'yan for the next few months. Talagang pagkakailangan mong lumipad, lilipad ka. Pero kung kuwari yung travel lang na pasyal, di ba? Baka, especially with your family, baka you put it off for another time na lang when things settle down even further. Ganun.
How about telco companies? Since a lot of people are using internet right now, data, mm-hmm. and a lot of people are also texting their family members, hey, kamusta kayo dyan? So, is it safe to say that telco companies are not really affected with this coronavirus situation?
Well, in terms of not really affected, siguro in the sense lang na hindi masyadong mag, di ba, hindi ganun din kalaki yung magiging losses nila. Pero it doesn't mean din na porket nasa bahay yung tao, automatically mag-i-increase yung spending nila sa mga telco services na yan. A good friend of mine nga, yung consultant namin, si Mr. Aaron Sai, no? He made a wonderful point nga na hindi naman porket naka-quarantine ka ngayon, automatically mag-a-upgrade ka ng DSL mo, di ba? Hindi naman mas magiging, di ba? Yung ibig sabihin, wala namang additional revenues na makukuha masyado yung telco sa'yo. Pero yun nga, hindi lang din sila ganun ka-affected kasi nature ng business nila is medyo separate from what affects from what the virus affects. So parang ganun. So in a way, pwede mo siyang i-consider as a defensive stock in the sense na baka hindi siya bumagsak tulad nung pagbagsak ng ibang kumpanya, pero hindi mo naman din pwedeng sabihin na taas ang kita niya dahil dito sa virus na ito.
Yeah. Okay. Got it. How about banking sector?
Banking, medyo mixed siya eh. Kasi merong measures na may mga measures na ginagawa si BSP to really help support the economy. Yung katulad nung interest rate cuts. So that's meant to increase the likelihood of borrowing from borrowers. Yung binabaan nila yung reserve rate requirement, so that allows banks to lend more money. So they can, in theory, generate more interest income kasi mas madami silang naipapautang. Pero yes, ang question lang is right now, are people inclined to borrow money? Diba? Yeah. If you're a businessman or a potential businessman, are you really considering this to be the perfect time to start a new business? Diba? Ngayon ka ba mag-iisip na, I'm expecting sales to go up in the next few months, diba? I'm not sure if a lot of people are really anticipating that right now. Baka ang ina-anticipate nila is the opposite. And so, if yung opposite ang ina-anticipate mo, baka hindi naman din logical na ngayon ka mangutang para mag-expand. Dahil ina-expect mo hihina ang benta mo. Diba? Parang ganun. So, yun yung ano, may measures in place that really aim to help the small and medium enterprise sector, and in effect, magbe-benefit din supposedly dun yung banking sector. Pero yun nga, it will depend on how willing the public is to really invest right now. Diba? How willing are you to start a business in this climate? Yeah. So yun yung question. Kaya medyo tricky yung sa
banking.
Medyo tricky siya. Supposedly okay eh. Kung hindi nangyari yung virus, maganda ang banking sector. It's one of our top picks kasi nga mababa yung inflation. Tapos yung expected growth natin before the virus hit was very, very good. Diba? Economic activity was supposed to go up this year kasi nga mas maaga na ipasa yung budget compared to last year. So, maganda sana talaga ngayon. Yun na, nagkataon lang na tinamaan tayo ng virus. Nag-shift talaga yung tone ng investing climate sa country natin.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So, challenge, parang ano, ang banking, medyo weird.
Parang hindi pa natin maano eh. Hindi natin masabi kung gaano ka willing. Diba? Gaano ka willing. Siguro ang maglo-loan dyan yung mga may existing businesses na para ma-ensure na kaya nilang ipagpatuloy yung operation ng negosyo nila. Pero yung mag-uumpisa ka, tsaka yung siguro hindi mo lalakihan yung loan mo. Kasi hindi ka sure kung kailan ba magiging business as usual. Kailan magiging back to normal yung sitwasyon natin. Diba? Yung mga may-ari ng mga small businesses dyan, when can they reasonably expect things to go back to normal? If they don't expect things to go back to normal anytime soon, why would you borrow money? A huge amount of money to expand your business when you know that there will be no demand or very little demand for that expansion. So parang ganun siya.
Mm-hmm. All right. Mm-hmm. Sige. Not sure meron ka bang insights about international stocks like nasa US?
Hindi ko siya masyado namang na-follow. All I know lang is medyo similar lang din yung sitwasyon sa atin. It's highly right now it's highly dependent on the virus, no? So especially siguro sa US na medyo nagpi-peak pa yung number of cases nila kasi I read somewhere na parang 30 of the 50 states pa lang yung nag-institute ng quarantine or stay at home measure. So there are 20 more states na medyo mas relaxed pa yung measures nila when it comes to combating this pandemic, no? So mag-i-increase, laki nga nung ini-increase nila every day, di ba? So that should be the main reason why their markets could also go down.
Kaya nga parang parang the world is, well, sinasabi na yun, the world is healing kasi walang pollution. On the flip side, meron naman siyang negative side. So parang, 2020 has been a year of wow.
From January pa lang, di ba? From the start of the year talaga. Talagang right after the new year. Yung volcano agad, di ba?
Volcano ka agad. Tapos, namatay pa talaga yung idol natin na si Kobe Bryant, no? Tragic pa talaga yun. Oh. And then, yun nga, parang grabe. Napansin ko rin, Robbi, no, na halos na mga depression or recession happens pag malapit na matapos yung decade or pagkaka-start pa lang ng decade. like 1929, 1997, 2008, tapos 2020. So parang bakit ganun?
yun yung normal siya na cycle. Minsan lang napoprolong siya government intervention. No, pero usually that's naman the normal progression. Kaya lang yun, sana hindi na tayo mag-fall into a depression. Kasi ngayon, mas creative naman na yung governments when it comes to finding solutions for problems. Especially kung medyo financial yung problema, medyo mas nagiging creative na sila. Di ba? Madami na silang naiisip na solution for that. Yeah. Kaya sana, because of that, hindi naman na ito mag-progress into a depression later on. And sana kung pwede maiwasan, of course sana hindi na din mag-progress into a recession, no? Pero that's something kasi that is talaga eh, kumbaga it's part of the cycle. Siguro you can only prolong it, but I'm not sure, no, kung if you can entirely avoid it. Pero this sana, one is serious talaga, itong virus na to, this is serious, and we should be treating this seriously talaga.
Yeah. So kaya guys, stay at home tayo, no, para matapos na tong dilemma na to, tong pandemic na to. Mag-go out lang tayo if we need to buy groceries or food or medicine, yun lang mga importante na mga bagay. And siguro last thing, since some people see that this is a good opportunity to invest in the markets, but they also need a broker. And nagkataon na First Metro Securities is one of the brokers of, like, dito sa Pilipinas that you can have access sa Philippine stock market. Paano ba sila maka-fund despite this current situation? Like, are you guys still open for funding or ano ba?
Yeah, business as usual kami. So you can still open accounts. Kung wala pa kayong trading account with a broker, you might want to consider First Metro Securities. No? One thing lang I'm particularly proud of is the fact na all online na yung account opening process namin. So actually, especially in this time na naka-quarantine tayo lahat, perfect siya. Kasi hindi nyo na talaga kailangan pumunta sa opisina namin, sa Abriza. You don't need to go anywhere. You can open your account from the comfort of your home. Just go to our website, firstmetrosec.com.ph. So, nakalagay na dun yung open account. Diretso na yun. So, makaka-open ka ng account line. Tapos, when it comes to funding naman, online na din. So, kung meron ka nung Metro Bank, of course, BPI, BDO, Land Bank, PS Bank, or GCash or coins.ph, you can transfer funds from there to your First Metro Securities account. Yung withdrawal din natin, online na din siya. So if you're already a client and you need to withdraw your money, just do it from our platform and it will go straight to your settlement account, to your bank account. So online na yan siya lahat. Kaya especially now, perfect siya. In fact, for some reason, nag-increase yung account openings namin sa onset nitong quarantine na to. So I'm guessing people appreciate that feature of ours.
Yeah. Magkano ba yung minimum for starters?
Okay. The minimum initial deposit is 2,500 pesos. So you need to fund online lang pa din yung pag-transfer ng 2,500, but you need to transfer 2,500 in order to fully activate your account with First Metro Securities. Yung 2,500 na yon, it's usable funds talaga. So hindi siya bayad. Hindi siya maintaining balance, hindi siya bayad. The 2,500 is your funding talaga, and you can use it to invest in the stock market or even in mutual funds.
Yeah. So guys, klaro lang, parang kailangan dito iklaro, it doesn't mean that when you fund your account sa isang broker, nag-invest ka na sa stock market, ha? So that's the first step. You need to fund the account, then you choose what asset class, like stocks or mutual funds. First Metro Securities is the broker, and maka-access ka sa stock market because of them. So yun yung paano ka nila how can they reach you or ask you information if maybe people want to ask questions? Do you have a social media handle or
you can add me on Facebook, no, Robbi Samson, or I can also give naman my ano my work number siguro here or ano sige you can contact me at 0917-891-4820. So contact me there. Naka-connect naman din yun sa Viber. So if you have Viber, feel free to Viber me. You can inquire, no? I would be glad to help you out. Kung may questions kayo about the stock market, about opening an account, about funding your account. Or if you want to just know where the stock market is, feel free to message me, no? So okay lang yun. Walang problema yun.
Ayan. So meron talaga tayong access kay Robbi. Like guys, if you don't know, Robbi is actually a celebrity sa financial market.
No.
meron din siya sa mga TV shows, no? Ano yung CNN ba 'yon? Yung
ANC.
ANC pala, ANC.
One News, yeah.
Yan. So nasa TV siya.
Occasional.
Occasional na sa TV siya. Ako wala ako sa TV, nasa social media na ako. So, ganun lang. Hindi lang. Ano lang. Parang at least you guys know that this guy is one of the people that that people actually listen to when it comes to financial sa stock market. Anong yung nangyari sa stock market? Because he really studies this. At the same time, he's also a practitioner in the field. Alright? So, and Robbi, anything that you want to say before we end this recording?
Okay. Siguro yun, no? Hopefully, we were able to help you understand better these trying times, no? Especially if you're an investor or you're planning to invest. Alam namin kasi kaya nga ako nag-suggest ng ganitong events with Sir John, no? Kasi I really appreciate the fact that kung ano man yung ini-invest niyo, pinaghirapan niyo yan, pinagtrabahuhan niyo yan. So it really is worth your while to try to understand as best you can where you are putting your money. So hopefully po nakatulong kami. Hopefully po nabigyan namin ng konting liwanag yung mga tanong ninyo sa sarili ninyo, 'di ba? Kung pagdating sa investments, and always remember lang na ayun, don't put all your eggs in one basket.
No? Yes.
Diversify. Keep safe. Kasi especially now, dapat ngayon na-appreciate natin yung value ng emergency fund. So, ito, biglaan to. Talagang in a span of a month, we went from working to staying at home. Di ba? So, in a span of 1 month, biglang nasira yung normal way of living natin. So, that only goes to show you that emergencies really do come from out of nowhere. So, ngayon dapat natin ma-appreciate yung value ng dapat may emergency fund talaga tayo. So, ingat tayo pagdating sa paglagay ng masyado malaking pera sa investments natin.
Yan. So, guys, kaya kailangan muna natin set aside yung emergency funds natin before we even invest. Kasi nga, investing kasi, sometimes the market will go up, sometimes the market will go down, and hindi ka basta-basta makaliquidate. Tulad ngayon, kung mababa yung market ngayon, tapos mag-liquidate ka, talong-talo ka talaga.
Yes.
Pretty sure. Pero yung emergency funds naman is like, regardless, it's actual cash, it's hard cash na gagamitin natin if in case na nawalan tayo ng trabaho or like this situation. Okay? So, yeah. Meron din siyang positive news sa akin. Like, since I'm not going around anymore, wala akong gas consumption. No? Di ba? Katipid ako konti.
True.
So, wala ng gas consumption. Pero yun nga lang, electricity-wise sa bahay, definitely aakyat. Kasi we are, you know, using electricity a lot here. So, ganun na. But Robbi, thank you so much for joining us today. No? And i-upload namin to sa Facebook natin. And sayang guys, actually the plan is for us to link this to Facebook Live pero hindi siya nangyari for some reason. So, kay upload na lang namin asap. Okay? So, thank you very much for joining us and see you on the next videos.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye-bye.